Hey YouTube, so as I said at the end of the last video, I ended up just having way too much stuff to be able to fit into one video, so I broke it up. Here is the second part. Thank you for being patient, and let's get started. So these next products are kind of outdated for the status of my hair, but I'm going to be brown again in my life. In fact, I'm mainly brown around my roots, and I will be red in the future as well, and these are red tinge. So some of you guys were like laughing, like, I know you just bought all that dry shampoo and now you're blonde, like what are you gonna do with it? Jonathan Green Routine dry shampoo in the medium, I think it is, or dark. I absolutely love this, as you probably saw in my super belated how I do my hairdo video. I use this in it. Basically, I love this for having a dry shampoo that blends into my hair when I have brown hair. It has a warm tone, so it's not gonna work for people with more neutral, cool hair, but I also like the warmth that it gave to my roots too, because I enjoy a look where like the roots are a different color sort of from the length, so there's just different dimensions to the hair. Obviously, I enjoy roots. So by the way, people who care about roots are like passionate as fuck about roots, because I can't even count how many people are like, bitch, you need to get your roots done. And I'm like, whoa. Number one, tone down the hostility. Number two, I'm sorry you have to look at these, but these are my roots and I want them. So people are, they're passionate about it. But listen, I grew up on Pamela Anderson and Baywatch. So I have always had like a thing for like rooty blonde hair. And it's a little grungy, a little rocker to be like super grown out, and I'm enjoying it. I'm having a moment, guys. I'm doing me. So, anyways, people are passionate about other people's choices, apparently. That was kind of the part of the reason why I kind of didn't want to make YouTube videos, in addition to that fact that I was busy as fuck. I just kind of wanted to go through a transition point, and the way I kind of like saw it in my head was like, you know, you go to high school a whole bunch, and then it's like you have the summer before you go to college, and you kind of want to reinvent yourself and like drop off the radar and like not listen to have someone to go like, oh my god, you're changing the way you dress, or you're changing this. I just kind of also wanted to like slip away and like not be on YouTube and have everybody giving me their opinion on what they thought I should be doing with my hair, or like that it was too yellow or whatever. So it was like I popped in here or there, but really I kind of just wanted to have just time to myself to do what I want and not have to hear anybody else's input. So I kind of just wanted some freedom and personal space as well. So that was kind of what was going on there. But anyways, back to the brown dry shampoo. I love this stuff. If you have brown hair, I highly recommend you try it out. I'm totally keeping all these, and when I go brown, whenever that is, or when I go red, I'll use these. Doesn't matter. I'm not really that worried about it. I like it. Keep it. Whatever. Let's continue on the subject of hair. Confession, I was kind of bad at Space NK in the past little while, and when they were having a sale, I bought a whole bunch of Orbe products. Woohoo. So this was a whole little kit, a purse size kit, which has the dry texturizing spray, which I use, and I've probably gone through a very large bottle right now. And it also came with the super fine hairspray, which I haven't tried, I don't know anything about. Then it also came with the anti-humidity spray, which I had heard good things about and I was interested in trying. And then lastly, here, it comes with the hair refresher, which I guess is meant to be more of like a dry shampoo. It refreshes hair, neutralizes odor. I need that, because with this blonde hair, I like to, this is, let's count how many days it's been since I've washed it. I think I'm on day 4, I think. 3 or 4, I think. I really enjoy just like slapping a lot of dry shampoo in my hair around day 2 and then just letting it get greasy and grungy. And when it gets to the point where it's like, I can't really take the smell of my hair anymore, then I wash it. But I find that I prefer how my hair starts to look in this cut around like day 2. The greasier and the grungier, the better. So something that's gonna neutralize hair odor is much appreciated. My hair doesn't smell bad today, but some days it's a little like, ooh, my word. And then also this is the Wave and Shine spray, which I bought separately. So this little kit I thought was great because it had all the different Orbe products that I wanted to try. I love the little purse size, it was super convenient. And then I got this bad boy right here, and I bought it when there was, I think it was like a discovery sale from Space NK. So it was like spend 70, maybe get like 10 off. So I just did like two purchases so that I would get $20 off in total. And some other things that I bought from Space NK, I can't remember, I think this might have been the only other thing that I bought from them. Actually, no, I think it was that as well. So this is the By Terry Balm de Rose. Yeah, I finally fucking did it. I bought the By Terry Balm de Rose. I gotta say though, I'm a little disappointed. For the price tag that you pay for the By Terry Balm de Rose, it's plastic, the top. I imagine the top being like a nice metal, like thick, heavy. Yeah, the bottle is like a frosted glass and it looks nice, but the cap feels so cheap to me. I was shocked. I was like, wow. I really expected it to be like a solid, like thick, heavy metal top for how much you paid for it, but it makes my lips look nice. I love the smell, a nice rosy smell. I feel like though my lips feel chapped after I use it. I'm not a huge chapstick wearing person. I pretty much keep the lip products I use to just down to like lipstick and then some lip gloss every once in a while. I'm not somebody who like had something on my lips at all times. I actually quite like the color of my natural lips, and so a lot of times in Instagram pictures people are asking me like, oh, what's on your lips? And it's nothing. I have, I think, just a complimentary lip color to what my face looks like. Sometimes I kind of like mute it out with foundation. Sometimes it's intentional, sometimes it's not. Sometimes it looks like shit when I do that. What are you gonna do? But anyways, the By Terry Balm de Rose. I'm not sold 100%. But if you are somebody who just likes to check out hyped products and luxurious things and buy kind of fancy stuff, which I am, so yeah, I'm not sold on the product itself, but I am sold on the experience minus the fact that I think the top should be like more substantial. So that is that. I think this was the other product that I bought from Space NK. I'm not 100% on that though, but this is the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Diffused Light. So this is the more yellow one. I honestly have not tried these out very much. I think I actually have now like 5 ambient lighting powders from Hourglass, but I bought them around the time when I was stopping wearing makeup as much as I used to. So I really need to like dig those up and try them a lot because I don't, you know, have an opinion necessarily to share, but I was really excited about buying them at the time because there was like so much hype around them. But yeah, I need to use them more. I know that I liked, I think it was Iridescent Light. I thought that one was really pretty, but I haven't given them enough of a go. I definitely need to explore them a little bit more. So when you buy from Space NK, obviously you get the wonderful little baggies with all the samples in them, and they're fancy samples, so they make me really happy. So this baggie right here came with samples of Eve Lom's Age-Defying Smoothing Treatment, I guess. Interesting. Eve Lom, I actually have never tried anything from Eve Lom. I think I've like steered away from it because there's the mineral oil in the cleansing balm that everyone loves, but I'll try it. Essential Shea Fekai Shampoo, cool. Always nice to have little travel shampoos. We got a Nuxe First Expressions Line Cream, cool. I'll try that bad boy out. And then Zellens Z Recovery Intensive Repair Balm. Ooh, I wanna try out some Zellens, so I'm excited about that. I really wanna get those like super fucking expensive exfoliating things from them, but be good, Chels. And then this bag here contains some Darf. Oh my god, this one has a shit ton of stuff in it. Maybe this was 2 bags in 1. I feel like I maybe combined bags. How many orders did I do at Space NK? Oh my god. Okay, we've got the Orbe Gold Lust Nourishing Hair Oil. Nuxe 24-Hour Smoothing and Moisturizing Emulsion. As well as a fondant cleansing gel. Fondant, like what goes on wedding cakes? I don't know. Like, oh god, I'm dropping everything. Okay, this video is so long. I just had to take a potty break. And it's been like a good 45 minutes since I started recording this video. Please, if there is a god, just strike me down and like make it be that there was lipstick on my teeth for this entire video, because that would be hysterical. I'm almost done. A product that I love, love, that smells so amazing. Dolce & Gabbana, the one. This rollerball is insane. I love how this smells. It smells so good. good. It's like this special little rollerball that I keep on my desk, and I put it on when I'm working in the day, and oh, I just love, because I'm like moving around doing things and I just catch the whiffs. I love how this smells. It's got like vanilla, mainly vanilla. I know there's like some amber, plum, like vanilla plum combo. I just love. If you like warm scents, I suggest that you check out Dolce & Gabbana The One, because it is beautiful. Kind of dumb to mention it, but I did get Laura Mercier Fresh Ginger, which you guys have seen me wear in, I think, a Get Ready With Me video, or I think I've talked about it and shown it, compared it to NARS Madly, very similar. It is what is on my cheeks today, along with the Kevin Kwan Sculpting Powder. Then we've got some Fresh Ginger, and then we've got the Kevin Kwan Celestial Powder right there. So that's the trifecta, the layer. Love it. So, on my eyes, I repurchased this because I had used up my last one and it had dried up and I'd love it so much. Makeup Forever Smoky Lash. Love this. Absolutely love this. By far, hands down, favorite mascara. The drier it is, the better. I got some brushes from e.l.f., just repurchases, because I do have each of these brushes, but I like them so much and I'm a kind of a lazy person when it comes to doing brush laundry, so I probably figured why not get another, so that way I don't have to do it. This is the one that is great for putting on foundation and stuff, and so, you know, why not get another one? I have way too many foundation brushes and not enough, I don't know, motivation to wash them, I guess. And then this is the blush brush from e.l.f., but I absolutely love this brush. It is incredibly soft. It is 100% amazing value for what it is. If you're gonna buy one thing from this video and you're broke as fuck, just go out and buy this at Target, because it's like $3, $4, $5. You can't go wrong. I use this for applying my highlighter because it's a little bit tapered right there. It actually looks a little bit different, I feel like, than my first one. Like, my first one, I feel like, was like a little bit flatter and you could see more like delineation between the different like layers of it. But anyways, it's just a soft, wonderful, if you want to just do a little bit of blush, go for it. But I love this for highlighter. Boom, love it. Works out amazing for me. The moment you guys have been waiting for, what anyone ever watches any of my videos for, lipstick. Let's get started with a fancy schmancy Dior Addict lipstick. My very first Dior lipstick. This is one of the Dior Addicts, I guess not extreme, I don't know. I'm not very well versed in the Dior lipsticks. This is in color 745 New Look. It is a nice, sheer, beautiful red color. And how great is this? This is the color and the lipstick that I was given for Christmas by the boys that I nanny. They went to Sephora and picked me out a fabulous Dior lipstick. So that thing is beautiful. Wear it by itself or wear it with a red lip to get a little bit more of like a glossy look going, but super pretty. I wish that I had this to show you. It's basically just another red orange, but this is one of the Bite, I don't know really what they're called, matte cream lip crayons. I can't find it. It's in Satsuma, which I believe is, or actually it might just be like straight up super orange. I think that might, it's somewhere in a purse. Yeah, sorry about that. Okay, another lipstick that I can't find, but you guys totally know what it looks like. Myth from MAC. I mean, come on, you guys know what Myth looks like. It's just one of those kind of nudie, naked lip, pinky, maybe a little peachy kind of colors. I don't know where it is. I really need to track down all of my makeup because I think it's mainly just in a bunch of purses everywhere. And then I put the purse in the closet and then I find the lipstick like 5 months later and I'm like, oh my God, this. But I do have some lipsticks that I actually have colors to show you. So this is a matte color from MAC and this is Flat Out Fabulous. Hello. It's a cool kind of like purpley pink color. So there was some sort of collection that, you know, came and went. And then there were ones that I think were still available on Nordstrom after a while. So I figured, let's do it. So it's a deeper pink than, if you know, it's a purplier pink, so it's a deeper pink than the crazy bright pinks that I typically find myself wearing, but I thought it would be a nice color and that it would be, you know, awesome. So that was Flat Out Fabulous, and then this here is Relentlessly Red, and I think these were like, what, like an Archie or something collection? I don't know. I'm just making that up, really, talking out of my ass, because I have not been paying attention to MAC collections whatsoever, but Relentlessly Red right here really to me is more of like Relentlessly Red Pink, but Yep, I thought that color would be very pretty as well. Because, I mean, look, this is a red, and that's, you know, not really connecting. And then this one is Dangerous, which I believe, you know, comes off more as a red than Relentlessly Red, but a nice matte red color. And so that right there is Dangerous. I have no clue if the three of these are still available. I do know they were from some sort of collection, but you know, there you go. Those are the lipsticks. I've been pretty good, you know, I haven't bought a lot of lipsticks. If those are the majority of the lipsticks that I have purchased in the past 6 months, I am doing good. Because I already have 500 lipsticks, there's absolutely no reason for me to be buying more lipstick, straight up. I'm gonna do one more thing. So, lipsticks didn't end at all. Woohoo, pretty lipsticks. But, so I've talked about this thing all the time. Whenever I do a get ready video, I'm always talking about the pencils that I love to wear. And they're the Smashbox iBeam Dumb Blended Brightener. I think they were discontinued by Smashbox. I think it was beauty.com that was still selling them. Someone alerted me to that, so I bought three of them, I think maybe even four, I don't know. But in the meantime, before I had done this, which I don't know if they're still available, if it was beauty.com or if it was Dermstore or something, highly, highly, highly recommend that you check these out if you can. Whoo, that is now the end of this ridiculously long, super overdue, everything I've bought in the past 6 months beauty haul. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys have an awesome day. Let me know if you have any beauty recommendations for me. Peace out. See you later.